All right. Welcome to Syllable Holic. I'll be diagnosing your favorite artist by doing bar breakdowns, looking for those bar gasms to figure out whether or not they deserve a refill on their prescription. Stay tuned for the results. I'm Dr. Lyrical Luck, your syllabologist for today, and our patient that we'll be diagnosing today is Tech9ne with Dysfunctional. If you didn't see the last video of Interlude with Lil Wayne, click that card here and let's dive into the content. Let's get it.
For Psychology 101, Dysfunctional. Yeah, don't you bring me nothing stupid. If you don't want me to lose it, step back. If you don't want me to attack, I'm a beast, better give me the deuces. Woo-hoo-hoo. I have no tolerance for nonsense, get away from me. Chill. Me, I wanna get dollars, don't wanna holler, but you making me. Chill. I'm a little dysfunctional, you the problem, please don't awaken me. Chill. And I'm that way, cause back in the day, most have forsaken me. Bloody naughty, I'm at the party.
Okay. He said, I'm a little dysfunctional, you're the problem, please don't awaken me. I'm that way because way back in the day, most have forsaken me. Meaning people didn't mess or rock with Tech9ne back in the day, right? And then he says, la-di-da-di, I'm at the party. I mean, that's a little homage there to Slick Rick, right? With his song, la-di-da-di. Damn. All right, let's see. What else, Tech? What else you got?
They most have forsaken me. La-di-da-di, I'm at the party. On a drunk night with a punk might do it, trying to pick a fight because he's sorry. Woo. That he ain't gaudy like I be cause he. Sloppy, not me, costly, rocks be spot free.
Oh, but he don't know. Hold up. I want to hear that wordplay again. What do you say? Gaudy, slop me, not be.
Sorry, that he ain't gaudy like I be cause he. Sloppy, not me, costly, rocks be spot free. Ooh. But he don't know I'm roguish, surrounded by my soldiers. And they be locked and loaded, when exploded you can't hold us. And we don't got no scruples, we didn't come to fight and shoot you. But your busters better be neutral, don't get loose because we cuckoo.
Yep. He said, dude, I got soldiers and they're roguish, you won't even see them coming. So he said, you better be mutual because if we get loose, we go cuckoo, so don't push us, right?
Call me genius, be neutral, don't get loose because we cuckoo. Listen, they call me genius, I run the show. Women, be on my penis, it's wonderful. Demons, you think they the meanest, but I'm
wonderful.
On the floor, a little bit sick, don't you know?
I'm a little dysfunctional, don't you know? If you push me, it might be bad. Get a little emotional, don't you know?
Chris Calico.
I'm a little dysfunctional, don't you know? If you push me, it might be bad. Get a little emotional, don't you know? Might fool around and make me mad.
So he's saying, hey, don't push me, because I might get a little bit emotional, and it's probably going to be mad. And you don't know what's going to happen when I'm mad. So just don't fool around. All right.
Make me mad.
So I'm a product of environment.
Yeah.
The game didn't change, so I've been forced into retirement. But I make moves and I pay dues and I got common sense. Since I can't.
Okay, all right, Big Scoob, I hear ya. Born to hustle, I'm a product of environment. Now, I'm a firm believer of being a product of your environment, depending on if it's a good environment or bad environment. Typically, the five people that you hang around the most is the person that you become or the person you are, right? So, he's like, I was born to hustle, I'm a product of environment, meaning we already know Big Scoob's background, right? He kind of grew up in the hood, so he's a product of that environment. The game has changed, so he's forced into retirement. He's saying the game from his day, right? Back in 2002, since then, it changed, right? It went from being actual, genuine hip-hop to being like pop music, right? So he said the game didn't change, so he's forced into retirement. What that did to him was it made his label go bankrupt in 2002. So, I mean, before he signed with Strange Music, after his label went bankrupt, at least he was able to, you know, hang out with his daughters and figure out, like, what the rap game's going to be if he could fit in. A little bit of tidbit on Big Scoob there, right?
Losing, forced into retirement, but I made moves and I paid dues and I got common sense. Since I can't lose and I can't choose, then I'll come back to spit.
Sounds like a businessman, a smart one at that, too.
I got hit songs, but I've been gone so long that I don't fit. Knew that the throne, but can't get down, so I need me a lick. I write these songs, but don't belong, I'm on some other shit.
That's right.
I'm hunting leads in desperate need, I hope it's coming quick. I rack my brain to find the land that's gonna bring me
me some change. But it's so strange, my life has changed and I am not the same.
Hold up, let's go into that wordplay for a second. He said, I'd wrap my brain to find a lane that's gonna bring me some change, right? But it's so strange, my life has changed and I am not the same. Now you could interpret that however you want. The way I'm interpreting is like, he was trying to find a lane in the rap community, right? And he found strange music, but it's so strange. So he found strange music. Now his life has changed and it's not the same for the better, right? Or you could be like, you could say, you could see it in a different way where his life is so strange, it's unreal. He's not used to that kind of money and fame or whatever. However you see it. Let me know how you guys see it. And if you're still with me here, smash that subscribe button, hit that like button. Let's continue on with the diagnosis.
Around, but since I'm down, it feels uncomfortable. I try to hide it deep inside, but I'm dysfunctional. I never learn to hold it in, I get emotional. First implode and then explode, I am combustible.
Damn.
So please don't push me, play me pussy on some real shit. Won't be defeated if I'm heated, nigga, I'm all shit.
Oh shit, hold up, all right. He said he tries to hide it deep, but he can't. He's dysfunctional. So he can't hold on his emotions. So he said, first I implode, then explode. I am combustible. Like an engine, right? A combustible engine. And then he said, don't push me. Don't play me. When I'm heated, I'm not going to get defeated. You're pretty much going to die. Oh, shit.
Push me and bite me back. Get a little emotional. Don't you know?
Oh shit, okay. He said, so I ain't no killer, but don't push me. Goody goody choir boy, never been no pussy. So he said he could be carrying something under his hoodie, right? He said he's a good boy, don't push him to the limits though. You don't want to see what's gonna happen. He's always been the good quiet boy that's packing he's packing heat under his hoodie, but don't push him.
What up? Chris would never snap and kill a ball of y'all or would he? Now I wanna be peaceful, but I carry desert eagles where ever black people are. You know how black people are.
Now we know what he's carrying under his hoodie. A desert eagle. Man, what a savage right there.
Peep him out. Try to stay even down. Wanna preach to him, but the evil keep on seeping out. Emotions get the best of me.
Okay. So he says, I peep him out and try to stay even out. Want to preach to him, but their evil keep on seeping out. He's trying to save as many people as he can, or at least help them bring out their inner goodness. But he's like, man, these people, their evil just keep seeping out. They don't even want to change. Some people just won't change too.
Messed up, but the evil keep on seeping out. Emotions get the best of me. Messed up, and then y'all get the rest of me. Depressed and stressed, but like my destiny. I know y'all think less of me, cause I'm always sick and I can't let it be. Pharmaceutical soup be the best recipe. It's gonna be the death of me. I need difficult just to cope. That's why I keep throwing them pills down my throat.
Hold up. We got a whole pharmacy coming in, and the doctor needs to speak on it, right? So he said, I can't let it be pharmaceutical soup be the best recipe. I need Depakote just to cope while I keep throwing them pills down my throat. Now, if you don't know what Depakote is, it's like an anticonvulsant. It's to help like treat seizures, bipolar depression, which we know that Chris Calico is struggling with. And also it could have some other minor effects like helping your headache or some shit like that. But yeah. He's like, he keeps throwing those pills down his throat. That's his pharmaceutical soup. Pharmaceutical soup. Anyway, continuing on.
Functional blood to do. Smoking Bombay can give me fun sway, but I wish that it all would go away. Or maybe I should pray for Jesus Christ and just impress on me. Try to pray for change, but sometimes it feel like he lets it be.
Ooh.
So I just take another couple doses, probably be fine. But if you get too close, you'll find out that I'm a
Oh my God. All right. He said, maybe I should pray to Jesus to unpretzel me, right? trying to pray for change, but sometimes it feels like he lets it be. So Chris Calico feels like his prayers aren't even being answered. Like Jesus is like, no, you're gonna stay messed up. So he just takes another couple doses, probably be fine, of the Depakote, which is sad, man. People shouldn't have to rely on pills, but sometimes people feel that way, man, when you're praying to Jesus and your prayers don't get answered right away. You feel like he's not even listening. But you never know, there could be some hidden blessings in disguise that you don't even know about. Boom.
Dysfunctional, don't you know? If you push me, it might be bad. I get a little emotional, don't you know? If you fool around and make me mad, I'm a little dysfunctional, don't you know? If you push me, it might be bad. I get a little emotional, don't you know?
Strange music.
The famous strange music at the end of the videos. All right. Now it's time to diagnose N9ne with dysfunctional. Does he deserve a refill? Smash that like button for yes. Hit that subscribe button while you're at it. Help me diagnose N9ne with dysfunctional. Let's get it. I'm going to say yes. I would definitely listen to that song on a playlist if it came on in my truck. I probably wouldn't go searching for the song just to listen to, but it does have replay value if it came on a playlist. Now, if you guys agree with my diagnosis, let me know in the comments. Smash that like button while you're here. And let's go ahead and find our next contestant to be our diagnosed patient. Who will it be? These are all your guys' requests, if you're still with me. I go through YouTube, find your requests for songs, and put them into these pill bottles, draw them at the end of each video to see who to diagnose next. I don't know why that one was in there. All right. And the winner is... NF. Returns. So if you requested that song, that is coming up next. I'm Dr. Lyrical Luck. I will see all of you on your bar breakdown follow-up. Peace.